Northwestern Medicine has been doing kidney transplants now for over 50 years. We're proud of the fact that we've become a leader in the field. New innovations, both clinically and in research, that advance the care for patients that are living with a kidney transplant.
Philosophically, we're a place where we're always looking for a way to make a transplant a reality for a patient. And that means taking on patients who are challenging medically, trying to figure out ways to use organs that otherwise at more conservative centers might not be utilized, and using therapies that can help turn a no into a yes.
We're doing 3 to 4 living donor kidney transplants every week, and we've been doing this for years. We've really gotten it to a science where we can make this happen so regularly and so successfully.
We began our laparoscopic living donor kidney transplant program here in the 1990s, and that really became a game changer for us, offering a less invasive operation for our patients. It allowed us to grow very rapidly into what has become the most active living donor kidney transplant program in the Midwest, and continue to be one of the largest and most active in the nation.
For about the last 10 to 15 years in the U.S., we've been doing something called kidney paired donation, where we take one donor and simply swap with another donor who has a pair with the opposite problem. So in 2010, we did an 8-way kidney paired chain. The ability to do incompatible kidney transplants has really been a big advance.
Not only does living donation help the people who are getting the transplant, but it allows access for people who don't have living donors on the deceased donor waiting lists. And so living donation is really a key to kidney transplant.
The other thing that our living donor transplant program has allowed us to do is to offer innovative therapies to prevent rejection without the need for medicines to control the immune system. We use what we call therapeutic cell transfer with donor stem cells, and have pioneered a number of approaches that have successfully induced tolerance here over the last decade, making us a destination center for tolerance induction approaches around the globe. One of our young patients who was involved in a trial where we combined both the kidney and stem cells from the donor became tolerant and went on with her life, and she got pregnant, and she delivered a healthy baby girl. She is the first tolerant kidney transplant patient off of immunosuppression to have ever successfully had a child. That was very gratifying and a real milestone.
Biomarkers offer the possibility of being able to individualize treatments for patients. And so we've developed a blood test looking at the expression of genes in the blood that can tell us if someone's having rejection in their kidney transplant without needing to put a needle in the kidney. That's what we see the future as: non-invasive, personalized medicine. And that's the research we're doing right now at Northwestern Medicine.
We're celebrating not only our 5,000th kidney transplant, but also 3,000 living donor operations that have made many of those transplants happen, and also 750 pancreas transplants, making us the most active pancreas transplant program in this region of the country.
It's one of the most impressive things in the field of medicine to take someone who literally is dying of an organ failure and restore them to a very healthy life. And when you think about that times 5,000, it's fantastic.
I think the sky's the limit in terms of what we want to do. We have a lot of experience here that has allowed us to get to this point, but every day we're always talking about new ways to make this better. And that, I think, is how we've become one of the best kidney transplant programs in the country.